بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أول جاست تو
كويشن.
تفضل أخي.
What is the true message of Jesus?
That's a good question. What is the true teaching of Jesus? Jesus himself said it. What Jesus said when the young boy came to him, he said, oh good master, what should I do to inherit the kingdom of heaven? So the young boy is coming to Jesus, the Messiah, the true Messiah, the mighty messenger. The young boy is coming to ask him for direction, for guidance. He said, oh good master, what should I do to inherit the kingdom of heaven? He said, why are you calling me good? No one good, only God alone. Then he said to him, what? Did Jesus say, believe I'm going to die for your sins? No, he said, keep the commandments of God. What is the commandment of God? The Mosaic Law. What is the Mosaic Law? The first commandment, what is it? Worship your God and love your God with all your hearts. What Allah said, وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا أَنْ يَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتِ. We have sent a messenger to every nation proclaiming, worship Allah and stay away from the false God. That was the teaching of Jesus. So the young boy said, oh, I've been doing it since I was young. Mean I have been preserving the commandments. Jesus said, you are lacking one thing. The young boy said, what is it? He said, give your wealth away and follow me. So that's what we believe. We believe if I was alive at the time of Jesus, the only way to get to God or to become righteous, you have to believe in God and follow Jesus' teaching. Before Jesus, believe in God and follow what? Moses' teaching. Before Moses, believe in God and follow Moses, Abraham's teaching. And now the last prophet is Muhammad, the son of Abdullah, the son of Abdul Muttalib, the son of Hashim, the son of Kaidar, the son of Ishmael, the son of Abraham. So you say there is no one worthy of worship except Allah. And Muhammad, the messenger of Allah, which necessitates believing all the prophets and messengers, including Moses, Abraham, Jesus. So true teaching of Jesus, in a nutshell, believe in one God and follow his teaching. Not as what Paul said. Let's fadal akhi. My brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, all the Christians, if Prophet Muhammad was the enemy, if he was the enemy of Jesus, how on the earth he would have a chapter named after the mother of Jesus? Imagine I'm a fake prophet. Do you know what I would say? No one will enter paradise except my people. And I would speak about my mother. Forget about Jesus' mother if I was a fake prophet. But to show you what, Prophet Muhammad السلام, had no control over the Quran. Whatever Allah told him, he used to say. There is a chapter in the Quran named after who? Maryam. And who is Mary? Mary in the Quran, Allah taught us to follow her way. ضرب الله للذين آمنوا مثلا مرأة من فرعون نعم دانا مريم. So Allah gave us example to follow. Who? The wife Pharaoh, she was a believer, and Mary. And this is a clear refutation against those who say that Islam oppressed women. Allah gave us an example of the Quran about two women to show the greatness of women and their strength and when they become true believers. So this chapter of Mary, refutation against the Christians and against the Islamic haters. Chapter of Mary, Allah defending Mary against the lies of the Jews at that time who claimed she was fornicator. Why Prophet Muhammad? And why you have to understand, my brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, when Prophet Muhammad was defending Jesus, there was no need for him to do that. Why? Because he was in Medina. He should have defended the Jews in order to gain more followers. Because if he's defending Jesus, he will go and guess the Jews and the Israelites in Medina. No, why? Do you know why? Because he shows you he's a true prophet and he's defending the true Messiah, Jesus. Look how clear it is. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Noon, wal qalami wa ma yasturun. ما أنت بنعمة ربك بمجنون وإن لك لأجرا غير ممنون وإنك لعلى خلق عظيم فستبصر ويبصرون بأيكم المفتون إن ربك هو أعلم بمن ضل عن سبيله وهو أعلم بالمهتدين. الله said نون by your Lord you're not crazy man oh Muhammad you're not crazy man oh Muhammad نعم you're not insane. They will come to know. They will come to know the truth. What happened to those who waged war against Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام? Where have they gone now? They went into the bin of the history. Allah raised Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام. Where is Abu Jahl? Where is Abu Lahab? Where is Walid ibn Mughira? Where is those who waged war against Islam? Those who tried to destroy Islam? Where have they gone? They went into the bin of history. And what Prophet Muhammad? Allah raised him. Over 1 billion followers. We love him, alayhi salatu wasalam. He took care of women. He took care of children. Imagine once he was walking and a young boy came to him and said, oh Muhammad, oh Messenger of Allah, let me show you something. Do you know what he showed him? A bird. Imagine a man of state, prophet of God, busy with his life, but he gave a time to the young boy. The young boy said, let me show you something. Prophet Muhammad held his hand and followed him. Allahu Akbar. When the Prophet Muhammad saw the woman that breastfed him, the woman that breastfed him, she was an Abyssinia woman, black woman. He used to stand up, take his clothes or the garment off and lay it down and he said, sit down my mother, my second mother. And they said, Islam is against black people. Liars, evil liars. How? Because they say there's a hadith in Muslim, Prophet Muhammad exchanged two black servants with one. You're a liar. It's not because they were black. Stop lying. Because Prophet Muhammad said, Bilal, who was a black man, is inside paradise. Abu Lahab, his uncle is inside the hellfire. How clear I can be? If I'm racist, no one enters paradise except my people. But Prophet Muhammad, his uncle, he said, will be in the hellfire. Bilal, black man from Abyssinia, in paradise. Alhamdulillah. They cannot wage war against us except they were lost. Allah said, Inna lanansur rusulana walladhina amanu fil hayati dunya wa yawma yaqumu al ashhad. We will give victory to our messengers and to those who believe in us. Inshallah, we stop here. Subhanakallah bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Wa sallallahu nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. بارك الله فيكم جزاكم الله خيرا. May Allah bless you, brothers and sisters.